People's like, the fuck? Maybe on top of the map then. Well, I wasn't at top, but I was like probably about fourth, I think I was. At top on my side. Oh my, I only had like 5 kills, 10 deaths. Fuck's sake, it's all that fucking reviving and shit I'm doing and then healing. As if he came out and just killed fucking shit tons of us then. It needs to be have some serious polishing to it, but I'm actually really enjoying it. I am. But my problem, our problems are, I'm proper big fan of like, the Warhammer universe anyway. But I'm different fucking ages.
I like Warhammer, bro. Don't like stuff just cause.
Well, that's what's swaying my vote, eh? Really. I'd like to say it's not, but obviously it is. I'm all engrossed because, you know, why am I? Yeah. It's simple as that, ain't it, really?
Yeah.
I'm not really a biased person when it comes to games. I admit that if they're crap or not, so. Not like I'm saying nah, it's the best game since, you know. I don't know, Fallout. But if you're going by fucking Fallout, Call of Duty, yeah, everyone says fucking Call of Duty is the best game.
Yeah.
Pretty much the eight.
Let Malona lead your blades.
How can we lose that man? There's no one defending the base. No fucker was defending the base, Ben.
The fuck, bro?
Would have thought someone would have been in, man. I was smashing him on that one. That's a smashing blade, I think that's one. Hopefully I won't get stuck with a team when no one defends the base system.
Usurper Scout. It's got an achievement on this.
Okay.
Yeah, somehow. Fucking is blue. Someone just bitch slapped me, I think. It was only because they were trying to get out the fucking melee, but they couldn't without letting the button go, I'm guessing. But still, the bitch ass motherfucker punched me, bro. The power fist. The fuck?
I hope you kicked his ass.
I was gonna kick his ass, but he's on my team and I ain't a cunt like the rest, bro.
I like this battlefield.
this tastes much better than game green.
Very sweet. Frog. You were just outside of tune then. Cheers, Bruce.
Capture the enemy base or kill all enemy forces. At the double! On me! Melee troops!
Dick, you need to kill me, bro.
Huh?
Said, what a dick, you need to kill me, bro.
We await
your command. Fuck.
No, Jesus, that flog, huh?
I've seen a couple of people just go all out, archers.
Let Valona lead your blades!
These spears, these men are literally flying somewhere beyond. This fight and still did not take damage from my own job.
Oh, we've heard Axis games, are we? Get loads of random shit like that.
Because I'm past the spears, I'm in regular melee combat, which is still right, you men.
Look at my fucking predator then. Holy fucks.
Thanks. right to this one now.
Sweet.
It's not sweet. Yeah, with me if it was a woman. Oh, if you can get me.
Tried to be helpful by taking a rhino transport over to this place we were trying to take earlier, and apparently we've been raped to A, so it's pointless there. Time is it?
It is. 19 minutes past 6.
Fuck. That went quick. You fucking knob, I could have saved him.
At your service. In service to Rome. For the dogs. In the name of Rome.
Yeah, sorry?
I'm just going, I can give an extra charge into this fight, but it would be point next to the village and have their arse to keep going and stuff.
Yeah.
You have to be destroyed on this one, man.
We're capturing the enemy base! Increase the pressure!
Come on, I'm not behind you.
open! Let nothing through! The main base! Increase the pressure! Leave no survivors! Suppress them! Captured!
See, but the Chaos players don't really help each other like the Space Marine players did, you know? And that's why. You are. True. Oh fuck you, you little cat prick.
By the way, that was just some really big thing with armor bars into the back of like 10 minutes by hand.
I don't think the cavalry hit very hard in that though, do they?
You have to hit and run, and I think you get an ability, a charge ability. Kind of like the thing where you, and what I've noticed is people click to charge right through rather than click to actually attack, they click on the opposite side of them, if you know what I mean.
Yeah.
So they don't stop moving, I guess, so they cut through and then carry on and then come back round again for a second attack and cut through again, kind of thing.
It's pretty neat.
Yeah, I think they're effective, but you really have to know how to play, you know what I mean. Once I've got Principes next, I can have Equites for rank 6.
Yeah.
So I might get a couple of melee infantry, the Republic's wisdom will see us then go to one Equite for flanking.
Meme.
I don't feel young, just dead and mean.
Twelve kills, 13 deaths, 3746 is my score.
Not bad, not bad. Not as good as me, but not bad.
No reason, breathe. I don't know whether it's good to bed or not, man. Don't look at stuff before, is it, Bruno?
No. I might head off 7 each, maybe. Because it's an early start, taking, so I don't want to be sick, like.
That's what I'm thinking about, going to bed now, like.
Just want to get in a couple of matches, getting closer to the start entry, like, yeah.
You're looking near Ramon on that though, eh?
Yeah. I think they're not as powerful as the Greats. I think the Greats are a bit more moving, but I know, like the Romans.
So. Probably because you probably find there's a lot more choice between the two of them as well for the Romans compared to the Greeks.
No, Greeks are very, to be honest, mate, on the trees.
Is it?
I think it's only barbarians at the minute because the barbarians haven't got the. They've only just been added into the game, kind of thing. So I think barbarians will catch back up, but I don't think quite there yet. The Greeks have got quite a lot of troops, and I think they do slightly overpower the Romans at the beginning. Because, well, I think the Greeks were the first ones added in because they've got 4 generals.
Yeah, probably.
Whereas the Romans have only got 3, so I think they started off with the Greeks. And then...
It's probably what they're OP as well.
Yeah. Just need to be balancing, but I actually enjoy this. With the right composition, you can still do well playing. It's took almost 5 minutes for this match, though. First couple of matches, I jumped right in with this one. Found a match for a
capture the enemy base or kill all enemy forces.
Swordsman! In the name of Rome!
to sound, Rove. By your command! And the double! Ready for orders! By your command!
Oh, I for Pi Day.
Press the advantage!
Money, money, money. It's what life comes down to.
He's already got three cavalry units himself, and there's a CP unit in it that's got three cavalry, and he's took all three of the cavalry.
Damn.
I've seen him in the last battle, and he's pretty shit with him. I don't know why you won there.
So, right, as long as I actually know how to use him, but if they're shit with him, then what's the point, really?
Suppress them! Fallen guards! Bring
if I get quite far, I'll see the film that's in the room.
Were you playing defensive, did you say?
Yeah, I went for a bit more defensive this time.
Sometimes it actually pays off for your team.
Yeah. Away team ready to attack and just hit some units on the side straight.
Follow me! Move out!
And it's
in service to Rome!
So I'm not really lost a lot of units now.
We await your command! Follow me!
Are you winning or? I felt like I was turning into Ryan then. You win, you win, fuck off!
Happy to serve Rome!
Man, if someone's controlling you, you should not let someone else control you.
Nah, definitely not.
Capturing the enemy base! Increase the pressure! We're capturing the enemy base! Increase the pressure! We're capturing the enemy base! Increase the pressure! We're capturing the enemy base. Increase the pressure.
No,
we did it. There's barely anyone left alive on either side.
Good match then.
Yeah. Like I say, I defended that arch right till the end, and he just retreated his arches. So there's none of them in the left. I'll wait till he's killed the monster and then join him.
The Republic's wisdom will see us to victory.
You quit the games and everything, Ben.
Yeah, I think I'm going to be off in a sec. I'm just having a mood through Facebook and then... Yeah, I'll go after I've had a butcher's line. Feel a bit crappy again and tired now, so.
Then I got in that button in 17 seconds and then.
Beast. I'll definitely go in tomorrow because it's going to be a short, well, it's only a short day, an early day.
Yeah.
Should be alright for me.
I don't like the early days, it means a bit of problem.
Fucking, I bought an ice lollop, right? Totally forgot all about it, it's all melted into its packet. Fuck, it's not opened or anything, so it's okay, but just totally forgot about it. Oh well, I'll just drink it, oh well. It doesn't bother me. I think I'm gonna have to go then, man. I'm gonna have to have a sleep, see if I can sleep the rest of this fucking bug off.
No worries, man.
I shall see you tomorrow.
Yeah, we shall. Have a good
one. Yeah, I'm definitely gonna. I could do it coming in tomorrow. I should see you tomorrow unless I feel really shit when I wake up, which I'm hoping I don't because I need to come in really.
Yeah.
I mean, so. I don't want to have too much fucking time on. Who's in tomorrow?
I think we have a Thursday on a Sunday, don't we? But Beryl has all weekend off now, apparently.
Why?
I don't
know,
just give it her
off. Oh. Look at your hair, Don't bug me, I don't really care about weekends.
And because Beryl works Monday to Friday in their other jobs.
Yeah, that's quite fair actually. It's James and Carl, get me. Fucking wanting for Friday off.
That's right.
James and Carl, both wanting Fridays off, didn't they? But then Maria ended up giving it Carl.
Did they? No, that's a bit.
Yeah.
Off.
A couple of weeks ago. You remember when Carl was bitching about the fact that he can't get the, to work because he comes on his bike if he's not got the car? Mm. Mainly because of that. Rob was meant to ask you, see if you'd swap a Friday with him.
Yeah, I said I'll do it this once, but not to bother asking me again. I've
got to
see the kids on
Friday, not seeing the kids before. But I said to him, if that's Dan, I'm sure he won't mind, but, you know, he's not going to want you to keep asking, like, it's not gonna, like, well, I said, he don't really want it to be a reoccurrence, like, he was like, no, I don't mind even asking this once, it's only going to be like a one-off thing.
That's what he said to me.
Yeah, that's me, basically, he showed Dan to do it, and I was like, well, yeah, the thing you can do is ask, and bro, I told him the same thing.
Yeah.
I was like, you don't answer, you ask. I think he's like me and Rob, we're speaking on, don't we?
Yeah.
Really well.
I said I don't mind doing this once, but I've got to show the kids on the Friday, so.
Yeah. Well, we all get on, it's just. It's James and Marie that annoy me. Well, Carl does too sometimes. He just comes out saying the same random shit here, and you're like, okay. It's not really an annoyance, it's more of a. Probably more feeling mentally raped. Did you? What would you say?
My mob was trying to shell derelict out to use a bomb. Many of my characters that were like to bent out of the tower.
Oh dear.
I
blame him.
Well, I've warned him already. And I said to Steve, if he carries on with you, I'll have words with Mike. If Mike don't sort it, I'll sort it myself.
To who?
Sometime in the day.
Well, if no one else will sort it, you got to, AM. I like Carl, but you've warned him and you've told him that you don't appreciate the stuff. Well, I think you said to him, didn't you? He said you don't mind him saying stuff to other people, like Beryl and Marie. It's just don't say it to your mummy.
Yeah, no, I don't mind him making dirty jokes or whatever. You don't say that kind of stuff to my mum. That's my mum.
I suppose it wouldn't be so bad, depending on what context you put it in. Like that what he says, where it's directly at it, because she's like, she's bending over the table, isn't she?
Yeah.
I guess. So, that's a really fine line between, you know, borderline sex pest, eh?
Yeah. Well, like I said, you can make dirty jokes or anything, you know, like we do, dick-sized jokes, something like that.
Well, your mum laughs at that, don't her? And like the gay jokes and stuff like that, she don't mind.
Yeah, but that's all fine, you know, as long as you don't talk sexual stuff at her, like you don't directly aim it at her.
Yeah. Well, you warned him at the end of the day.
Yeah.
You know, you don't appreciate him saying that stuff to your mum. Okay. To be honest, even if your mum didn't mind him saying it, you do. Yeah. And you should have, you know, respect the fact that you actually mind.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because it's your feelings that is upsetting, really. Well, more pissing you off, really, than upsetting, but you know what I mean.
I know what you mean.
Yeah. I know. I don't think he can help himself sometimes, can he?
Well, I think he gives anyone's mind the gaze really pissed off, and that's what he should understand, you know. I'm sure if he was my age and someone was saying that kind of thing to his mum, he wouldn't like him.
No, too, I wouldn't like it if it was my mum. Although my mum would say, fuck off, you weird pervy bastard.
Yeah.
My mum said, you know what my mum said, you know, we was all in the pub, right, and we was all having that drink. I can't remember what it was for, but it was when Steve got pissed.
Yeah,
it was, yeah. And you know, my mum and dad was in there.
Yeah.
And then he shook my mum's hand, and my dad's.
Yeah.
My mum went, I went back, said, fuck out, that bloke was a bit of a creep, boy. I was like, fucking spot on, to be honest. I was like, we're calling him Raimi for a reason.
Yeah. I just don't get it, man. It's like I said, I'm warned him. It's not like I haven't told him.
Well, you basically went up to him with respect and said, can you not, you know, say stuff like that to my mum, or, you know.
Yeah, exactly. It wasn't being a twat then. But if I have to be to get the point across, I will be.
And there's your mummy. I can't blame you. Yeah. If you would have told somebody and they don't take the fucking hint.
Yeah.
The whole tough love scenario is going to have to come out to you.
Yeah.
Be a cunt to be kind in the long run.
And Steve's like, don't get yourself in trouble. And I'm like, well, if he carries on, Steve, regardless of the consequences, you know, I'll get my point across.
Too right? At the end of the day, Steve should be thinking the same thing.
Yeah.
Really?
He pulled him aside and had a word with Matt to have, but, you know, I think he's more for the fact that I was pissed off than anything else, you know. Whereas he should be pissed off with him saying it himself.
I don't think Steve wanted to cause any tension, you know what he's like. Yeah, he likes to get the peace if he can. But at the end of the day, you can't always keep the peace. You're gonna have squabbles and quarrels, or whatever they're called.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because Carl's that sort of person, ain't he? You know, he sort of picks out the women, don't he?
Yeah.
mean, his sisters are all looking gay and everything. He's like before, he's in fear for his ass. You know, there is a line that you don't want.
That was bad, I thought.
Yeah.
I laughed at it, don't get me wrong. I thought it was quite funny, but then I was like, okay, I'm laughing at it, but that's because it's rapey as fuck and I find it funny, but he shouldn't be doing that, you know. That's like me going up to like your mom, feeling her ass, and then going, it doesn't matter who it is, it's not right. You know what I mean? You're not even in a relationship with that person, you shouldn't do it. The closest thing you should do is like, you know, shake their hand, give them a hug or something.
Yeah. Like memory and me over each other and stuff. But, you know, I never lower my hand down to an arse or anything.
Well, let's face it, you easily could, couldn't you?
Yeah, exactly.
It's mutual respect, though, that is. Me would probably let you. She was telling me the other day that she was having problems at home and stuff.
Yeah,
she was just like, you know, you, Steve, and Beryl now. And I was like, nah. I says, well, as far as I'm concerned, Marie, you haven't told me nothing.
Yeah, I
never
got to
share the problems. The only reason I told you just then was because she told me that you were in there, or else I wouldn't have said nothing.
Yeah,
yeah. You
know
what I mean? So, I've really got so do I, as a person I do, just not as a colleague sometimes, because she's really lazy, isn't she, like, as you well now?
Well, I mean, so, it means they have volumes out because she dragged him down sometimes.
Yeah, that's the one thing that, like, pisses me off the most. She's dragging him off of, like, a smoke here and there. You know, I said to Steve when we was on that long night, didn't I?
Yeah.
You know, I said to him, I don't want you going there for a fag, it's just her, you know.
Yeah, she drags him back and then she makes him think he can get away with doing nothing as well, just because she thinks she can get away with doing nothing.
She said the other day, a proper guy, because her only reaction was walk off and smile. Basically what she said was the classic, oh, I don't have to do anything because I'm in charge, basically. And I says, yeah, but you lead by example, Marie. Lead by example. And then she's like, you know, because she couldn't say nothing to that because it's true.
Well, I said to Steve the other day, at the end of the day, there's no shift managers and supervisors. You don't have any paperwork. So it's not like you can make an excuse for sitting in the office all night. You know, you have to do something, that's what you're there for.
See, your bro, I can't say a bad word about him when he's when it's his like shift, when he's in charge. But when it's him and her, he doesn't annoy me, it's her, she's dragging him down, I know that.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Because I've seen it. She goes, oh, I'm coming out for a fag, and he's like, ooh, yeah, go on then. Because she's playing on his addiction, isn't she?
Yeah.
Yeah. So, I reckon she's just doing it to make herself look less bad, but she's making herself look worse to me. In my eyes, because I know exactly what she's doing.
I don't think that's it. I think she just wants to have a smile. And she ain't got the willpower to say no. To a smile, you know what I mean? Because he could easily say no, Marie, you don't want to go out with you. If you have the willpower to do that.
True. He just frustrates me because I know your bro, he grafts and then she's like, wanna come out for a smoke?
When she
wants
to do, Marie can
properly
finger out.
She can what?
When she wants to, she can properly finger out.
I know, yeah. She just don't do it anymore because I think. Because me, you, and Steve. Well, it used to be just you and Steve, really. It used to be grafting, but now that I know what I'm doing. I know where, because you never know where the stock goes all the time, like some food, do you? It's there's just an area where you know it is, isn't there?
Yeah.
I know where most shit goes now, on all the sections. Apart from confec, I'm still not a good confec. I've only ever, you know, considering Hale not being there, it's the one I've done the least. And the one I like doing the least, you know.
I'm good with Confect, but he's always getting moved around.
Yeah, I think that's a bit because of Beryl moving around, I think.
I see, I absolutely adore Beryl, but she's terrible at Confect.
I know, I'm Bautist.
She never organises it properly, it's always a mess. Like, brands aren't next to each other and that kind of thing. And I absolutely adore Beryl, and I'm not slagging her off. But.
No, I love Beryl.
It's just.
Don't worry, I seen it when Steve was re-merging it. I was like, you know what, I've never really looked at Confec and thought, fucking hell.
Yeah.
That's bad, that is, because you get past anything with chocolate bars.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
But, I mean, I swear, the amount of times I've had to re-merchandise Confec in the past, because Tony really cared about how it looked, whereas my man that bothered because he never gets around the corner. And a week later, it's messed up again. You know, it's like,
she needs someone to set her. You need to, you know, put your finger in and just keep it all together.
We've said that before. I mean, Steve's, when we did the massive move where we moved the whole store around, we said to her then, keep it exactly how it is now, just top it up. You know, the beam said, if it's over, if you can't fit in the gap where it was, put it on old stock, you know, but she always ends up messing it up anyway.
Yeah, she probably does it for like a month max, and then she just forgot and she's like, oh, fuck it. Yeah. Probably over that long. She just don't give a fuck, does she? Oh, fuck it.
I think it's because she works every job, she don't work
it. Yeah. To be fair, you can't blame her, though, can you?
No.
Yeah. It's a dodgy place out at our work.
Yeah.
To be fair, I don't like dislike anyone on our shift. But people do annoy me, but that's just, there's only two people that actually do annoy me. I can't say I've had a bad word against. I haven't had a bad word against anyone apart from probably Miri and James, really. Miri just gets on my tits and so does James with his excessive moaning. Other than that, James is okay.
Yeah, I don't mind James too much, but he's pissing me off lately. And Miri, I mean, I really get on with Miri. I really like Miri, so she's lazy, but she's really nice with me.
Don't get me wrong, personality wise, I can't knock her, like, as a person.
Yeah.
It's just work. You know what I mean? I could happily get in the pub and talk to her and have a laugh with her and everything, but at work, it's like I said, like the little things that start annoying me.
I think the fact that the fortune or the misfortune of knowing the previous supervisor, though, who was lazy as hell, as lazy as Marie, a complete bitch with him. I mean, complete bitch. You know, like a tiger, it's like, you know, a good thing really. She's a nice person, even though she's
mad. Yeah, it could be a lot worse, don't get me wrong. But I think you need someone to piss you off at work, just because then you can get through it a lot easier, I think.
Yeah, she gets more stuff there.
Yeah. Because don't get me wrong, like I said, I don't dislike anyone. It's just, there's little bits that, like, fuck me off. Yeah, there's only you and Steve, and probably Rob, that don't piss me off.
Yeah. And I think Rob could piss you off,
don't you? He's too dope, yeah, you can't be angry at a dope person. So to the down, so I'm gonna have to start calling you fucking Dopey John. Okay, I'm going to bed now anyway.
No.
Alright, I'll see you tomorrow anyway. Well, literally later actually, yeah. But yeah, I'll speak to you later anyway, mate.
Yeah, see you later, mate.
Alright, in a bit, dude. Yeah, I'll try, man. See you later.
Capturing the enemy base! Increase the pressure! Capturing the enemy base! Increase the pressure!
literally to another meeting.
Capture the enemy base or kill all enemy forces. On me! Move out! At the devil! Enemy has drawn first blood! Push back! Sons of Mars! Repel them! Hold the wrath of Rome! Knock them down! Yeah. our units has recovered! Back into the fray!
Move road!
At speed! We're capturing the enemy base! Increase the pressure! Capturing the enemy base! Increase the pressure!
machine. Fucking lazy. This guy and that fucking idiot there. Fucking useless.
We're capturing the enemy base! Increase the pressure! Our base is being captured! Quick, to its defense!
We watch this.
Capturing the enemy base! Increase the pressure!
Don't you give me fun, which I need.
Thank you.
poisonous fucking idiots, man. I fucking swear. Thanks for watching, guys, and I'll see you again soon.